Alright, what's up my fellow EST and Machine Gun Kelly fans? I'm back this week with another new video. This one was highly requested. This is a reaction video to Lately. I love the beat on Lately. I could listen to this beat all day.
Oh my god, Bonnie.
Lately I've been having crazy thoughts. Yeah. The way I'm living shit get crazy dark. Tell me lately why we barely talk. I'm trying to change, but it's very hard.
I challenge you to listen to that part and look me dead in the eye and tell me that that is not a cry for help.
I'm still dealing with some demons that ain't really there. Grew up a screw up, pierced my ear and dyed my fucking hair. In seventh grade, I didn't have a bed, I had to share. The fuck you think I go so hard for? I got out of there. Have you ever had somebody try to take your life? Sometimes I ain't safe from myself when I stay up at night.
I'm going to assume that have someone try and take your life part is about his schizophrenic cousin that tried to kill him in his sleep, if I'm remembering that story correctly. And as I could imagine, yeah, that would probably affect you having a sound night's sleep ever again. Now, largely, this song as a whole so far is a cry for help. We get him talking about his past, but really it's not really a celebratory way, kind of. It's just more of a explanation for why he is kind of in the fucked up state he's in now, I guess. I also really love like the look like your teeth are about to fall out of your skull filter they put on this.
9 years old, my mama left me in the cold. God damn. Hey, what you think that type of shit do to your soul? Find someone that finally loved me, still I treat her like a hoe. That shit is
I understand that line completely. That does sound fucked up, but I get it, especially with that kind of traumatic thing happens in your childhood. I had a real issue for a really long time where I couldn't trust women. Women, just because of things that happened with my stepmom when I was a child. And so I understand that does have a traumatic effect on you, especially when you're a child, and that can hold over for years, especially if you don't try and work through it. And I'm not going to say he hasn't tried to work through his issues, but clearly there's still more that needs to be addressed there.
It be the shit that they don't know. I only smile in public just for show.
It makes me really sad.
I know they try to warn me about my dose. You know them kids be with the A and now them kids be seeing ghosts.
I know this is going to sound like I'm really overhyping that, but that is really a great line. With the, they try to warn me about my dope and kids be with the yay and not on kids be seeing ghosts. Great lines, Kid Cudi, dope, kids dying, but kids seeing ghosts, the album. I don't know, it's great. Never mind, I'll shut up about it because you all probably already realized it. It's not that hard to figure out anyways.
Lately I've been having crazy thoughts. Yeah. The way I'm living shit get crazy dark. Tell me lately why we barely talk. Hey, you know I'm trying to change, but it's very hard.
The scenes in this music video are amazing. Just the way they filmed, especially with the the water running over his head. And the shots of him in a hotel just kind of looking strung out by himself, getting high. Or that's kind of like the Kells I imagine when I hear about him doing all these drugs and everything. And just kind of going out of control. This part here is really important because it really emphasizes the serious and intense nature of the song, like the tones of it. I understand it's disguised pretty well and that the song is like pretty good vibe. It's a pretty good listen, like it's a jam, but it's very serious and it's very serious undertones.
Lately I've been having crazy thoughts. Yeah. The way I'm living shit get crazy dark.
Now we're back to the hook. That to me is a cry for help. I mean, Christ, look at him in the video. And granted, that's probably the point, but he looks fucking gone in the video. He looks smacked. He looks out of here. Like, he looks like he couldn't even walk without anyone helping him right now. And I guess, you know, like, that's kind of the point. But I mean, like, even at the end, the last scene is him pulling the blind back down on the airplane. I guess because it's too bright. And I feel like, what are you usually seeing, like, movies and TV when someone that's a drug addict? They can't handle the direct sunlight, it's too much for them, so that might be a reach there, but that's what I feel when I look at that. And so, I guess overall, let me say this, because I want to make it clear, this is my favorite song off of Binge. I really love this song, but this song is a cry for help. This song is disguised very well. He did what Future does extremely well, and that is that he made a song about how shit is not right with him, how he needs help, he needs to get his issues addressed. But he made it a jam, he made it a bop, and so no one either cares, or they don't notice, or they're just like, ha, lol, same. And so I hope that he can get these issues addressed. I kind of thought I don't know why, but I had thought he had this like all very well under control, and then when like leading up to Bloom, he had that little incident on stage where he didn't have a heart attack. I guess it was a heart episode. You might know what I'm talking about. His heart just kind of like freaked out, and they were like, "We don't want you to go back on stage," but he had decided to go back out anyways, much against everyone's warning. He ended up being fine from that. But then, especially with 27 coming out on Bloom, it was like, okay, like, this is very real. Kells very well might die, especially because of his lifestyle he's living. And I was very afraid and worried about that for him. And I had actually kind of started to come to terms about what if this guy, who's this artist who had been such a big part of my life for such a long time, if he were to die this way. So I kind of had prepped myself for it already there. I know that sounds foul, but I think it was necessary. And he just needs help. And he looks very strung out in real life, too. He needs help, and I hope he's able to get that help that he needs. On a much lighter note, I want to say thank you to everyone that's been watching my videos and has subscribed. My channel has really grown a lot in the last 2 weeks, and I really appreciate all the love and getting to meet and talk with everyone and getting to discuss. And some people who I've shared a lot of music with, some people have shouted me out and been really helpful to me. It's been really awesome. And just a big thank you to everyone. And, you know, I hope that we continue to grow and we continue to be able to be a community for Kells, and we continue to be able to share, especially if your opinion disagrees with me. Go ahead, let me know, because that's the best part about this. It's, music is all subjective. Art is all subjective. It's important to have a conversation about it. You know, maybe help people see the angle from, you know, your point of view. I guess lastly, I really hope you enjoyed this video, because this is my third attempt making this, because the first time, like a fucking idiot, I didn't have the video hooked up to my earbuds, I left the fucking TV on, I had the fan on, so all that shit was going on in the background, I don't know why, just being stupid. And the second time, I just didn't focus the camera. That was on me. But I hope you enjoyed this video, and this has been the 804, and please make sure to like, share, and subscribe. And don't forget to spread the word, keep the vibe alive forever. And lace up.